this section mainly focus on what is correlation, then how many types of correlation. This is the area I'm going to focus now. Yes. The meaning of the correlation. Actually, the word itself, you can easily find it. That's called correlations. So co means we need two or three people, then only we can co. That's why if you go with some company, the co company or Mannar and Co. So they're using the co means it comes two or three partners, because of that only they are using the terms co. And the same thing, while you want to check the relationship, we have to use the term as a correlations. In the correlation, we are going to find the relationship between more than one variable is considered as a correlations. Correlations considered as a number which can be used to describe the relationship between two variables. So minimum condition, the minimum thumb rule for doing a correlation, minimum the two variables needed. For example, normally the people are confusing with correlation as well as the associations. Do you have any idea what is the correlation? Normally the correlation value, we know that that value is goes plus or minus one only. Why the value is not goes above the plus or minus one? Any logic is behind? Please kindly give a response in the chat box. What is that? Why that correlation value is not going above the plus or minus one? Why it will be limited to plus or minus one? Any reason? Any reason? Please, I request the students kindly give the responses in the chat box. What is why the correlation value is not going above the plus or minus one? That's a question for you. Suppose if you are not knowing, I will give the response for this. Actually, why is not there in the sense? Actually, correlation is nothing but a commonness. Commonness between the two variables. For example, why the lot of diversity happen in the family in the sense? Because the commonness or the common characteristics of each two member, husband, wife, is not much. That is a lot of problems coming. Sometimes we are using the terms made for each other. So what is made for each other? Because they have a lot of common characteristics. Both are look like a same characteristic. That's why even if you go for marriage and all, we are checking the horoscope. The horoscope, what they are doing, some people are checking, they are telling this, there's a 5 match or 6 match, then you can go for the marriage. So that matching, what is meant matching? It is like, it's nothing but a commonness between the two people. Characteristics and personality and all. They're checking with the commonness. Commonness normally, for example, if you're compare with the one person along with me. So now what you're telling, compared to him is okay. Compared to him is not okay. Like that you are giving one answer, no? So what it represents compared to one person to another person, you are checking the commonness, common characteristics of the two person. Then finally he's telling that he's okay, he's not okay. Like that you are giving you one answer, but you are comparing the two person on some category. Here you are checking, for example, suppose you are seeing the person's like me in somewhere. You are telling that, oh, he's look like a Tiago sir. Like that you are telling, you know, why you are telling? Because my face assemblance is to equal to the that other person's assemblance. So it here it shows the commonness of my face as well as his face is to look like a same. Therefore, you are using the term his look like a sir, like that you are telling, you know. So here, the commonness normally won't be reached more than 100%. For example, if you want to compare the good quality of you as well as your husband or any life or that you are checking with the commonness, that normally the commonness value don't go for 100% more. So when you are telling us and he's very perfect, the perfect means 100%. So if you go with 120%, it's not possible while you're using the word as a percentage. So normally if you want to compare any two things, we are checking that how much percentage of assemblance, how many percentage of things to be compared to each other is same. So therefore we are using that 80% common is there, 90% of assemblance are there, 100% of assemblance are there. It means that while one variable is equal to the other variable, we are telling 100%, it's called as a perfect. So there, because the reason only the common, that what is that, the commonness value while you're talking about the percentage don't be reached more than 100%. The same thing in the correlation also, the correlation value is not going plus or above the plus or minus one. Why? In the sense, it is checking the commonness between the two variable. So that commonness never to be go with 100%. The same thing, it not never going to be above the plus or minus one. Here 100% represent, for example, you are telling some people asking in what way you are what is that compared related to your husband or your life partner, you are telling that we are both are look like the same characteristics, 100% same. Some people are telling we are totally 100% to be not matched. So 100% not match is called as negative correlation. 100% match to each other, that is called as positive correlation. I hope you mean it. So there is a chance 100% not match, 100% match. So the 100% match is nothing but a plus one value. 100% not match is nothing but a minus. That is called as a negative correlation. In this way, we have to easily explain the name is that concept is called correlation. Then normally in the correlation, lots of types are there. So even the positive correlation, negative correlation, zero correlation, the positive correlation also, there is another division is called perfect positive. These are the types are there. But while you are using the number of variables, we are using the two different names. One is called simple correlation, other one is called multiple correlation. For doing a simple correlation, we need only two variables. For example, I am comparing with my intelligence with achievement. Intelligent achievement, intelligence one variable, achievement is another variable. If you are comparing the two variable only, then you can do simple correlation. Multiple correlation means it's immediately you can understand multiple means more than two variables. I have the two, three variable like intelligence, steady habits, as well as the achievement. So if I comparing with the three variable, I can use the multiple correlations. So for that, the minimum conditions to minimum three and more variables needed. The same thing partial correlation, in the sense there is a chance the third variable, for example, x is an independent variable, y is a dependent variable, the third variable z also may influence on the scoring of the particular dependent variable. For that, what we have to do, we have to nullify the effect of this z variable, then we can check in what manner the independent variables depend, making the impact of the dependent variable after controlling the effect of the third variable. That, for that, we can use the partial correlations. So this is a way, based on the number of variables, we can differentiate the names for simple correlation, multiple correlation, or the partial correlations. The next thing, properties of correlations. Already I mentioned that the correlation value is going, maximum value is plus one. The minimum value is minus one only. So this is a basic condition. See here, this is a value of the correlation coefficients varies between the plus or minus one. Actually, this is called R value is zero to R above the zero to plus one is called as a positive. The scores zero towards the negative side up to the minus one is called as a negative coefficients. If the score is nothing but if the score comes as a positive score, we can call as a positive correlations. If the scores of the correlation value, coefficient values come as a negative, then we can call as a negative correlation. It's very simple. The correlation normally you are using bivariate analysis. If you are using more than two or three more than three variables, we can use the term as a multivariate also. When the values of the correlation coefficient as lies around the plus or minus one, then it's said to be perfect degree association. Suppose the answer of your correlation coefficient value is plus one, it means a perfect is nothing but 100% match with the two variables. If you are having the scores like minus one, it means 100% not having the match. So from this we can easily find out that whether it's a positive perfect positive or perfect negative. Perfect positive value is plus one, perfect negative value is called minus one. As the correlation value goes towards zero, there is a chance some comparing, if you are comparing the two variables not associated with each other, there is a chance there is a zero it may come. For example, the color of the person, actually the achievement you are checking. The color of the person as well as the achievement. So what will happen? Damn sure that it won't be matched color as well as the achievement. So even the color with the intelligence, we cannot be comparing because the two variables could be different context. If you are comparing these two variables, there is a chance that relationship may go to zero. This kind of variable, the coefficient value, if it comes zero, then it's called as a zero correlation. if you are taking this zero correlations as a researcher, the problem with the research side, because you could not be find out the which variable may impact the different variable. The problem with the research side only. So therefore, we don't be select this kind of variable, X and Y. If you are taking as an X, should be making some impact on the Y. Then only we can use that kind of code. Now, I move to the next slide, scatter diagram. So in the last semester, we are talking about the pie diagram, histogram, and frequency polygon, frequency curve, and all. But for checking the correlation between the two variables, we can use the diagram as a scatter plot or scattergram, scatter graph, or correlation chart. This much name is there, but generally we are using the term as a scatter plot. This diagram is drawn with the two variables. Usually the first variable is independent variable, second variable is dependent variable. Normally, we are using the term independent variable here denotes as a X. So the X is for the independent variable. So the X is for independent variable. The Y is for dependent variable. So I hope you understand X is represent independent variable. So X always to be make it impact on Y. For in the case now we are the raining season, but if you see the comparison of your food habit, little changes. Previously you won't take the regular, what is that, frequently food, but due to the rainy seasons, what is that, the cloudness as well as the coolness is happens around us. Therefore, what it happened, we want to be equate that heat in our body, we are eating much. So what is happened, there is a chance of, there is a impact making our temperature make it one cause, that is called as a cause and effect. What is the cause? Our temperature of surrounding, it makes a impact or effect on eating habits. So I hope nowadays you are taking little high of food or taking much food compared to the previous days, because due to the that temperature is low. The scatter diagram is used to find the correlation between these two variables. So we are using the term the scatter XY plot as point that shows the relation between these sets of data. Now I'm going to the next slide. This is a diagram. See here, this is a diagram we can easily find out. Actually, the road terms, we can use that normally. Statisticians, we are using the two different terms for the correlations. One is called R, other one is called, I'm going to pen. R is represent for the Pearson product moment correlation. The rho is represent the rank correlation. But don't be confused here. So normally this is also is correlation simple only. So generally I'm comparing here. If the R scores, if it comes minus one, the diagram may comes like this. See here. So the diagram you can easily found. There is a line. This is called as a fit line. From the fit lines only the three, actually I have only the three scores, X, Y. So from this, the three dots, three points, it will be lies in the same points, the same line. So it means that the scores not scatter much. It may come as a linear mode, linear. And also see here, this is an X axis, this is an Y axis. So if X is increase, in this case, Y is to be decrease. Y is decrease because the reason only, this diagram is coming. If X is decreased, Y may be increased. So this is a logic, this kind of diagram is coming. So to see the diagram, the line is comes like here, left to right. The line, higher views, lies on the left side. The lower end of the straight lines comes to the right side. But in the case of positive correlation, so negative correlation, this is for the perfect negative. In the case of negative correlations, see here, there is a line, but the scores may lies in or scatter in different places. So here the lines or the dots are scattering around the line. It's not lies this exactly straight line. If the dots or the scores are lies in the same straight line, then it's called as a perfect. But in this case, it's not like somewhat scatter around the line. Therefore, it's called as a negative correlation. But I already mentioned that the line, see here, the higher end it's in the left side and lower end in the right side. So if the line is comes like this, in this way, then it's called as a negative. If it opposite, then it's called a positive. See this diagram. So here, this is the lower end. Lower end, it starts from the left side, left hand. Then right side, see here, the top end, it will be the line also to be different side. It is like left to right. This is left to right only, but the positions of the lines to be differ. In this case also, see here, it goes like this. So if the lines comes like this, this is called as positive. If the lines goes like this, the scatter, the scores are scattered like this, then it's called as a negative. But if the points, if the all the points is lies on the same line, the same straight line, then it's called as a perfect positive. See here, this is perfect positive because there is a 4 points, there is a 5 points. All the 5 points lies on the same straight line. Therefore, it's called perfect. But in this case, there is a 5 points, but the 5 points is scattered around the, it is around the straight line. It's around the straight line. Therefore, it's called as a positive only, not in perfect positive. But in this case, see here, this is another diagram. This is an example for no correlation. So if I draw any line, see here, nothing's matching. If I draw positive also, if I draw negative also, so the scores is like a lot of outliers are there, parallel, it will be scattered. It's not like equally scattered. See, in this case, in this image, there is a positive negative correlation, but the scores just very near to this straight line. Because that only we are able to draw one line center. But in this case, even if I draw the lines like this also, we could not be, the scores are not equally scattered around the line. So therefore, it's called zero correlations. So based on the image itself, we can easily find out, or based on the diagram itself, we can easily find out the correlation types. This is another diagram, scatter diagram. See, in this case, independent variable X, dependent variable Y. Here also, the scores are scattered. Lot of scatter is there. It not goes in your own way. If I go with the positive correlation line also, see here, the scores, it will be distributed or be scattered, it not in a very perfect way. If I go with positive negative also, if I draw the negative correlation line also, it only comes, it means that the scattered of the points, no, it not distributed properly. But this image, see the second image, suppose I am drawing the straight line based on the points here. So what it means, the question for you. Now see here, there is a independent variable, dependent variable. I request the students kindly give the response. In the independent variable X, dependent variable Y, it means that if X is increased, Y also increased, or X is decreased, Y also decreased. Suppose I am drawing the line parallelly to this scattered that things. What kind of correlation is this? See here. Here, all the dots is somewhat near to the lines only. So what it means? What kind of correlation is this? Please, yeah, very good. Saranya has said it's called positive correlation. Whether it's a perfect positive, when it will be perfect positive, when it will be perfect positive, if that scores are, or the scattered points are to lies on the same straight line, then it is called as a perfect positive. Very good. The Surya is correct. See the third diagram. So there is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, there is a 5 dots. It means finally 5 scores are there. So based on this, I can draw one line. See the line. This is a correct line. It's like a straight line. All the dots, all the scores lies in the same straight line. It means it's called perfect positive. But this is very close. See here, there is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 dots are there. But even though if you're drawing the one straight line, 5 is above, 5 is down, but very close to each other. Suppose there is I am putting one more point here. So these are the points. Okay. So I am marking some other points. Okay. Then what kind of correlation comes? It may be a positive, but correlation, it may be a weak correlation because the scores is to be distributed much area in the blanks to the that particular straight line. So here lot of scatteredness happened. Therefore, it may be positive, but it's a weak positive correlation. I hope you understand the meaning of the correlation. Now this much types of correlations are there. One is called positive correlation, perfect positive, negative, perfect negative, zero correlation. Then based on the curve type, we can use the term as a linear correlation. Non-linear. Linear, we know it's called straight line. If it other than the straight line, if it comes in, it's called as non-linear. We will go one by one. what is positive correlation? The positive correlation is a correlation in the same direction. See here, this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis. I am drawing the line, I am drawing this straight line. If you draw the straight line, see that the scattered around, the straight line. So around the straight line. So what it means, if the x is increase, y also increase. If the x is decrease, y also can decrease. This is called a clear positive correlation. I hope you may get it. In this case, that example IQ and achievement. For example, IQ, I put this course like this. And 10, I am putting this course 10. And 20, 30, I wrote like this. Then 40, then 50. So very poor handwriting comes. Okay, the same. This is for the intelligence course. Otherwise, IQ, IQ. This is for the achievement. For example, I put the achievements like 30, 40. I put like 25. 50, this is for 50, just for, yeah, this is for 75, this is for 100. Okay, like that there is a two axis, x, y. In this, what is the point it notes? This point, see here, nearly is 18. Therefore, x, y. Now that we know the each point having the two axis, x, y. X is called abscissa, y is called as an ordinate. In this, we can easily find out that 18, it's nearly 15 here. So related to 40, so 18, 40. Therefore, each point having some scores. So from the scores only the diagram is coming. The logic of the positive correlation: if increase in one variable, then it increase the value of another. It means that x is increased. Suppose I'm drawing the line like this. If x, so I'm writing like this, x, y. If x is increased, y also should increase, right? Then I am taking the another pen. Suppose x is decreased. If x is decreased, y also should decrease. So then it's called as a positive correlation. I hope you understand. Just I'm dividing. So there is a two scores, x, y. X is called independent variable. Y is called dependent variable. If x is increased, y also should increase. X is decrease, y should be decreased. This is called a positive. So it means that the commonness is goes to the same direction. For example, I am going to one way, you are also going along with me, my direction. Suppose I am going towards Kasaragod, you are also towards Kasaragod is coming in the same. We are both going the same directions. So it means that the same direction we are moving. It's called as a positive. But in the case of the lot of family, what they're doing, the husband is going one direction, wife is going to another directions, the family life is very questionable. So that is called as a negative because each person is going to different direction. If the family want to be go in a perfect way, we have to adjust to each other. What do you do? Based on the husband, based on the wife is going. Based on the wife, the husband is moving. So we have to adjust to each other. So, but it's not be possible this kind of variable. For the example, I'm telling like this. Here, I'm highlighting some of the example, IQ, academic achievement. Because IQs increase, those who are having the high level IQ, damn sure the academic achievement is high. If there's some people having low IQ, so for them, the low achievement scores may be there. Then speed and distance. So if you are going very speed, you may reach the, you may cover a lot of distance. If you are going very low speed, you may cover very slow distance only. Then the next things, training for training as well as the performance. So if your training increase, performance also increase. If the training is low, your performance low. This is called positive correlations. This is perfect positive. Perfect, there is a little difference between the positive and the perfect. Perfect positive means the same way x is increased. See here, I am putting the diagram x, y. There is a two variable we have, but in this case I am putting like this. Okay, x is increase, y also should increase, but in the same proportion. The term is called same proportion. See here, so x is increased 10, y also increased 10. So this kind of same proportionally it may add it. The another example, if x is, I am going with another example, if x is decreased with one proportion, the same way y also should decrease. So that proposition means that, for example, the x is you are increased 10, y also should increase 10, or some accurately may match. For example, x I am increasing 10, y always increasing constantly 15, 15, 15, then also it may come as a perfect positive. For this case, see here, I am putting the diagram. So what it means, I am draw the line like this, 1, just for example, 2, 3, 4, okay, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, there is a 10 numbers. So the problem with my handwriting while using here, 3, okay, 4, 5, 6, like this coming. Okay, see this point 1, 2, this is called 3, 4. So this 4, 8. So here the points, no, it here what is the 2, I'm taking as a 1, 2. What is 1, 2? If one x is 1, y is 2. If x is, for example, or the x is 2 in the sense, y is 4. I hope you understand. So the y may comes here. If x is 3, y should be a 5. If it goes like in a perfect way to be increasing or decreasing the same proportion, then it's got less. Yeah? Perfect. The best example, the speed as well as the distance. For example, I'm going with the speed. So S is for the independent variable, speed. Then Y is, I'm taking as a speed, then distance. Okay. Suppose I'm going with the 10 kilometer speed. Uniform, like exactly uniform velocity is needed. I'm going to 10 kilometer speed. So within a 1 hour, how much distance I can cover? Within a 1 hour, how much distance I cover? 10. You got clear? So if I go with 20 kilometer per an hour, how many kilometer I may cover in the distance? 20. So don't think that it, x and y should be same. In this example, it may come like this. Suppose I'm going with 30, okay. 30 kilometer speed. So in the first hour, I may reach the 30. The same thing if I go with the 2 hour. So this is for the 1 hour distance. I'm going with the distance covered in the 2 hours. On the 10 kilometer speed, if I go within here 2 hours, I may reach 20. If I go with 20 kilometer speeds, I may reach within the 2 hours, 40 kilometer distance. If I go with 30 kilometer speed within 2 hours, I may reach 60. See, in this case, this is x is 10, y is 20. X 20, y is 40. X 30, y is 60. There is the same proportional. What is the proportion? Here it increased 10, 10, 10. But here increases 20, 20, 20. So now you got clear. There is the same proportion. Uniform velocity may change, then it's called as a perfect positive correlations. In this example, I'm drawing the line. See here. Based on the scattered, if I draw the line, automatically all the points, what we have, all the observation what we have, it may lies exactly in the straight line. Therefore, it's called perfect positive correlations. The next, this also another example, height and weight. See here that line. This is called a linear, because when based on the scattered or based on the scores you have, if you are drawing any line, it matched to the scatter points, but in a straight line form, then it's called a linear correlation also. This is a perfect positive correlation. I'm going to the next example. Then high degree of positive correlation. See here, we already know that the line is goes from left to right, left to bottom to right up, then it's called as a positive, left to down, then right side up directions. But see here, that scatteredness very narrow, very nearer to the straight line. Therefore, it's called as a positive correlation by high degree. So high degree means the scatter, that points should be scattered around the lines very limited. So the width, see here, the width is very low. The width is very near to the, it's nothing but the uniformly the scores are scattered around the straight line. Therefore, the scores may come R equal to plus 80. It's called positive correlation, but in high degree. Suppose if I go with other one, other example, the same, it's also positive only, but see the scatteredness. See the scatteredness. It will be very much scattered around the straight line. So this much of difference or that compared to the previous one. See the previous one, the scatteredness is very low, but here the scatteredness that around the straight line is very high. Therefore, it is called moderate positive correlations. Then the scores becomes 0.1. So that positive represent the positive correlations. The next diagram, see this also another diagram, but see the diagram direction, the straight line directions. In the left side is to be top, the right side it should be down. Therefore, it's called as a negative correlations. But the negative correlations around the straight line, the scores are scattered much. So here the symbol represent the direction. This is represented magnitude. Normally, in the correlation, there is two things important. One is called magnitude. So magnitude as well as the direction. So the direction denotes the this kind of whether if you get a positive score, it's called positive correlation. If you get the negative score, it's called negative correlation. This is called direction of the correlation. This is called the magnitude, the strength, the strengthness of the correlations. Even we can tell us a negative correlation, but there is a chance negative strong correlation, negative low correlations, that also may come. These things we may discuss now. Now, I'm going to talk about the negative correlation now. Yeah, negative correlation is a correlation in the opposite directions. So I already mentioned that the straight line may come like this. See here the straight line, the left side may be a top angle, the top it may be left side, the right side, the line comes like this, but in a downscroll arrow it may come there. The scores are scattered around the straight line, but the direction it shows is negative. So what it means, x is increase, y is decrease. So in this case, if x is increase, y may be decrease, right? Or x is increase, y can be decrease. This is called negative correlation. Negative correlation is a correlation in the opposite direction. Negative correlation occurs when an increase in one variable decreases the value of another. The negative correlations has range between 0 to minus 1, so towards the minus 1. The example, practice time plus errors in typing. So this is a best example. What if happen if you are increasing your practice time? You are increasing the practice time. This is called independent variable. So if you are increasing or you're increasing time of your study, what it happened, your error committed during the examination should be less. Even that's called practice. So while you are doing any statistics, you know, if you are doing lot of practice during the examination, you won't do any mistakes. But if you have the low practice in the homes, it may reflect the examination. So you may get do lot of errors while you write the examination. Therefore, the practice time increase, just time there. Practice time increase, error is to be decreased. But if your practice time is to be decreased, your error may increase. I hope you understand. So the practice time as well as the error adding the two variables, the relationship will be negative. Then sale of woolen garments, this temperature decrease. See here, now very cloud nature. That's why we are using some woolen cloth and stuff. But in the normal days, while you go for the normal temperatures, high temperature, we are not using the woolen garments. So what it means, the woolen garments, it's nothing but the sweater, may increase. Okay, woolen garment, so sale of woolen garments, when it will increase, when the temperature is decrease. But when the sales of woolen garments low, in the sense, when the temperature is to be high, very hot situation, we won't be wear the woolen garments. Next is called speed. Previous case, in the positive college, we are talking about speed and the distance, but here speed and time. For example, if I going with time, going with x comma y, so there is a line x comma y. Okay, so x comma y. Okay. X comma y. So here in this x is called speed. I'm going to 10 kilometer speed, right? If I want to cover the 100 kilometer, if I go with 10 kilometer speed, it reaches 10 hours. I hope you understand. For reaching a 100 kilometer, if I go with a 10 kilometer speed, it goes 10 hours. Okay. Then if I go with a 20 kilometer speed, So that what is happening? So here, which is increasing, x is increasing, but y is to be decreasing. How many hours it takes? 5 hours. I may reach within 5 hours to the under. The next thing, the pressure, Surya's given pressure and volume. Exactly, in the physics, the pressure and volume. Next thing, I'm going 30 kilometers speed. So 30 kilometers the speed within 3 hours plus 10 minutes or 20 minutes enough to be reach the one place. So it means that x is increase, y is decrease. So see this, if x is increase, y is to be decrease. So this is a way we can easily merge with the things. Now the speed and the time, price and demands. If the price of the costumes or price of the anything to increase, the demand is very less. If the price is very low, the demand is to be so high. This is called negative correlations. What is the perfect negative? So the same way when you are talking about the positive, perfect positive, there is the same proportion. So what is the proportion? This time writing x comma y. So in the x comma y, x is decrease, y should be increased. Okay, this is we know, but it will be equal proportion. For example, there is a constantly the 10 is increase in the x or 10 is decrease in the x. Parallelly, y having the constantly may increase 20 or 30 or 15, but the constant it may be increased. Suppose x is increase constantly, y are same proportion, y is to be decrease. So the same opposite. This is called as perfect negative. The best example, we can use the term, this also, what is the speed and time. It may come here perfectly. This is why the scatter diagram may come. TV watching per week. So now the question for you. In this, which is a x-axis, which is the independent variable, which is a dependent variable. In this diagram, there is two variables. TV watching per week, one variable. Then exam. Okay, there is another variable, which is an independent variable, which is an exam score. Which is an independent variable in this? Which is an independent variable? So, kindly tell. So, in this case, TV watching may be independent variable. Then exam score may be dependent variable. Yes, very good. So exam score may be dependent. So we can adapt. Normally, x may be independent variable. In this case, they are shifted in a different way. Yeah. Now the next diagram. But see here, in this case, the scores may come like this. What it means, all the dots, all the scores may lie the above the straight line. Therefore, it is called perfect. Here, the minus symbol represent direction. Direction of the correlation is nothing but negative correlation. This is called a magnitude. What it means, very strong, perfect. It means that if you reach one level, one may represent 100% mismatch. In this case, minus, it means that there is no relationship. It means that there is a negative correlation, not a relation. There is a negative correlation between, negative perfect correlation between the TV watching per week and exam score. Another example, the same example I'm telling here, but here I'm going to the another group of people. Their findings comes like this. See here, but in this case also there is a negative line only is coming, or negative, but the distribution, the scores are scattered around, somewhat very near to the straight line. Therefore, the R value is minus, it's called magnitude. The 80, it's called 80%, 80% not matching. Or, so what it comes, if x is increased, y is to be decreased. That is called negative, but 80% strong is 80. The next example, no correlation. What is the no correlation? So now we are talking about positive or negative. The no correlation means, if you are selecting two variables, the two variables not having any relation with or no association between each one, then it's called as negative correlations. The chance of one situation never affect the chance of other situations. It means that x won't affect the y. I hope understand. X won't be affect the y. Then it's called as a zero correlation, because there's only zero correlation is coming. The value of r is to be zero only. The example, color. The color of the person versus intelligence of the person. It won't be having any relationship. because it's another variable, it's another variable. It won't be matched with each other, okay? So the shape of the head versus intelligence. Sometimes it may be there, but shape of the head versus intelligence, they're given as an example. The music skills and playing skills. So because music skill is aesthetic skill, playing skill is like a psychomotor skill. So it will be both, it should be different. For example, I'm checking with my driving skill with my teaching skill. Can we compare with the driving skill with the teaching skill? Both are same. Please kindly give the answers. If you're comparing with the driving skill, so because driving skills are different for certain way. Teaching skills are different. Two is different. If you're comparing, there is a chance this kind of zero correlation becomes. Here, why is called zero correlation? The scores may scattered around it. Even if you draw any kind of, for example, I'm drawing the positive correlation symbol. If I draw the positive correlation symbol, I'm taking a red color. Yeah. Then, yes. So I'm taking the red color. Yeah. If I draw a positive correlation, the scores not around that. If you go with negative correlation also, no. If you go with the horizontal line also, the scores lot of distribution scattered. Therefore, it won't say positive or negative, may zero correlation. The another example also, see here, the scores are scattered like, what is it? It's not like it goes in one way direction or two way direction. So we could not be check this kind of two variable, which means that the investigator cannot select a proper independent variable, dependent variable, due to the cross like this kind of things may come. Now we have this question for you. What kind of correlation is this? It's already there. No correlation, because if you draw one straight line down, the scores are scattered. We could not be go with, if you go with like the also, see here, this much of scatterness there. If you go with the negative also, that much scattered. Therefore, what it happened? This kind of no correlation may happen. See the two variable, IQ and height. So whether we are able to compare with IQ and intel height, nothing. There is no match between the two variable, IQ and height, because only no correlation becomes. If you go with the other variable, now you have to tell what is this one? Whether it's a positive, the first diagram. Is it a positive or negative? Please kindly give your responses in the chat box. Is it a positive or negative? This first diagram. Yeah. So here the positive, very good, positive diagram, very good. Arya, Anu, Sri, Prashna, everything is correct. But here the scores, what is the score? 0.80. Represent what? Represent what? It is a strong, whether it's a strong correlation or very low correlation. The level is different. If the score is very near to the 0.2 or 0.1, it's called low positive correlation. But in this case, not perfect. Saranya, if it's perfect in the sense, it will be +1. It's not perfect, it's called strong. I hope you get it. Saranya and Drisha. Perfect in the sense, the R value should be +1. Then only is called as a perfect. In this case, I had rather learned the scores are distributed in a close circle. So like this, it may come, because recently the diagram is coming. But here the strongness is called 0.80. It's called only strong positive correlation, not in a perfect. Right? But see here, this is called, 0.80 if the score scatters like this. If the scores comes like this, if the straight line also likes comes like this, the scores may comes like this. This is called +0.60. It is called what kind of correlation? Please, I request the people give it. It is called positive. Very good. Prasanna is correct. This is called moderate level. Actually, we can categorize the scores. If the scores less than 3, it's called as a low correlations. So a lot of categories is there, but we can easily look on the divisions. If you more than 80, we can call as a strong. If less than 0.20 is called low. In between the 0.2 or 0.8 is called as a moderate. Like that, we can easily categorize. Otherwise, some standard correlation, they are given a different. They go with very strong. They limited with if you go with 0.80, the score is very strong correlation. 0.80 is called strong only. If you go with minus or +0.10, it's called as a very low positive correlation. Different people are using different, but as a layman, we can divide the scores into only three: low, moderate, high. What about this one? This is called also low, because 0.40, it's called otherwise moderate. We can use the moderate also. If you go with less than 0.20, then it's called So this only 0.20 only is very low, very good low. So it means that the distributions to be much. Yes. Now I'm going to the next diagram. Yeah. So still now we are talking about the five correlation. One is called positive correlation, perfect positive correlation, negative correlation, perfect negative correlation, then zero correlation. Now I'm moving to the linear correlation. So linear is nothing but a straight line. The relation between the two variables can be explained with a straight line. For example, in the diagram and all, every scatter we are draw like a straight line. From this only we are comparing. The scores are scattered, look like a straight line path, then it's called as a linear. But the scores comes like this. See here, this kind of curvature, if it comes, the scores are scattered like a curve shape, then it's called as a non-linear. So I hope you understand, linear means straight line. This is called linear, this is called linear, this is called as a non-linear, this is called non-linear. The change of two variable is in same direction or opposite directions. In some cases, after that, it may differ. For example, one time may increase, the y may be, so x is increase, y is decrease or increase sometimes, then immediately may decrease. Lot of fluctuation may be that increase, decrease, then non-linear may come. But in the linear, the relation between the two variables can be explained with straight line. The chance of two variables same direction or opposite direction. If the quantum of change in one variable has the ratio of change in the quantum of change the other variable, then it's known as a linear correlation. For example, an individual has more intelligence, his performance, any field will increase. This is a normal example. But non-linear, it's like a lot of fluctuation may happen. So it may, sometimes it may, y is increased, then decrease, increase, decrease. Like one curve shape may go there. If you go with the sine theta, cos theta diagram, no, that kind of diagram may come. If an increase in one variable, another variable increase up to certain direction and then decrease. See here, this word is important. When the amount of changes one variable is not in constant ratio, that changes the other variable. For example, rainfall relates more production. So the case of the last year, if it good rainfall or normal level of rainfall it comes, the production may high. If heavy rainfall, what did happen? The entire agriculture field is to be making a problem, because everywhere the flood did happen, that the entire agri things to be struck up, because more number of more rainfalls affect the production. So that is called, sometimes the rainfall increase, production may increase. If it more increase rainfall, what did happen? The production total is to be down. This kind of conditions, non-linear, curvilinear may comes. Just I'm going to highlight the area. Yeah. This is where, this is a perfect example. A perfect positive. You are asking what is a perfect? X is 30, Y is 30. X is 29, Y is 30. It's like equal, but don't be look on it. Suppose X is 30, I put like 40 also. Then X is 29, Y may be 39. So in this case, the increase one, decrease one, Y also decrease one. There is a same ratio. It may, so there is a constant level, it may increase. X is increase and decrease. The same constant ratio or another constant ratio, the Y may increase or decrease. This is called perfect negative. See the case 30, 21, 29, 20. And it means that X is increase or X is decrease. In this case, X is decrease. See here, X is decrease, Y also decrease. This is called perfect positive, but the same proportion. But here, in this case, X is decrease. Why, what happened? Okay, so here in this case, X is decrease, Y is increase. So this is called perfect negative. The zero correlation, there is no match. So a lot of scores may be scattered here and there. Then it's called a zero correlation. I'm going with another example. Perfect parity, in the sense there is a same proportion may increase. See here, 30, 29. The X is increase one, decrease in one constant. But in the case of Y, also decrease in 2, 2. So not 1, 1. It's also 1, 1, but somewhat equally. 42, 40. Here 38, sorry, there is a mistake. 38, 36, 35, somewhat scattered there. That is why it comes like this. It's a positive, but the perfect should be like this. Sorry, I compared with this is called positive. X is decrease, Y also decrease in this example. But X is increase in the perfect positive or decrease, the same proportion X, Y should be increase or decrease. But negative is to be before. Zero correlation, there is no relation between the X and Y. So it may be scattered here and there. It also regionally actions like this. Other types of correlations, it's not really directly comes into your syllabus, but just to, as a researcher, you must know. Perfect, he knows, there is the same proportion may increase or decrease, then it's called perfect. Strong means the scores more than plus or minus 8.0 to towards plus or minus 1, then it's called a strong correlation. It means a very close relationship between the two variables. Weak means that scores very low, less than, it's called 0.2 or 0.3 or minus 0.2 or minus 0.3, then it's called weak correlation. The partial correlation normally we are using only for finding, if you are using the three variable, the third variable effect we want to eliminate, we can use the partial correlation approach. So I hope you understand the thing. Hopefully now we understand the relationship between the types of correlations as well as the other things. Just I'm going to summarize what is the correlation. Correlation must be the commonness between the two variables. Why the commonness value is more than, it comes only plus or minus 1 in the sense, it's like a percentage of the closeness or commonness between the two variables. The percentage of the commonness won't be reached more than 100%, or it won't be go mismatched with 100%. So it won't be go more than that, because the reason only the correlation value also, it goes, the limitations only plus or minus 1. The plus 1 represents a positive correlation, minus 1 represents negative correlation, 0 represents zero correlation. So now we are talking about the phi correlation, one is called positive. Positive means x is increased, similarly y also increased, or x is decreased, y should be decreased. But in the perfect positive means the same proportion of x and y may increase or decrease. That is called perfect. The negative correlation, if x is increased, y may be decreased. But in the perfect negative, what it happened? The same proportion of x is increased, the same proportion of y may be different. Or it's vice versa also. But in the zero correlation, there is no relation between the x and y. Yes. I hope you understand what I said now. Thank you so much for your patient listening. Now I'm going to be stop screening. Otherwise, I come for the other example with my Excel. It may be good for you while I'm doing with the Excel sheets, okay? Yes, so because people are having confusion with that scatter diagram, normally these questions are frequently asking the NET examination also. The questions, what did happen, how we can be measure which diagram is more appropriate for finding the correlation between the two variables. Further, the answer is scatter diagram. Now, just I'm going to be give the example. See here, there is an X and Y. This is an X and Y. Now you have to tell what kind of correlation. I'm going to draw one diagram. You have to tell what kind of scatter diagram. So this is the first pair. I'm going to select the first pair. Just I'm selecting the color like this. The first pair, this color I'm using. I'm selecting these two variables, X, Y. I'm going to draw a, I'm going to insert, I'm going to scatter diagram. This is called scatter diagram. I'm selecting the scatter. Right. Now you have to tell whether it's a positive correlation or negative correlation. Please, this is a platform for you. Then after that, I can wind up after showing this diagram. Yes, very good. It's called positive. Yes. Whether three classifications I'm telling, whether the positive, it may be a weak correlation or a strong correlation or a perfect positive correlation. It is strong. Very good. Anita is correct, because suppose I'm going to draw with the line. Double click it, I'm going to draw one straight line near to the that scores distributions. Then I'm going with the trend line. To go with trend line, there is a linear. Yeah, see here, there is a diagram. Now you got the lean. I hope all of you get the straight line. The straight line is coming around that only the scores are scattered. Therefore, it's called strong. The line also goes this way. So from left to right, left to right in the top way is going. It was called positive, but it is strong positive. Very good answer said by the Sashuri and Bhavana. Now I'm delete this one. Okay. Now I'm going to the next diagram. This is another variable, another two variable I'm going to select. I'm giving the another color like a green color. So font I'm making a single color. Yeah. This is a two score, 30, 40, 29, 39. I'm going to do a same kind of scatter diagram. So the scatter diagram is coming here. Yes. Now we have to tell what kind of diagram is this. So just I'm going to add a straight line also. So just I'm going to trend line. This is a trend line. Yes. Yes. Very good. Aria is correct. It's a perfect positive because the same proportion of increase or decrease I have is there. That is why, see here, that straight line, in the above the straight line, only all the points are the line. Therefore, it's called perfect positive. Thank you so much for calling response. I'm going to the third example. So I'm going to another color. Yeah. But different. Yeah. Now I'm going to the third example. 30, 30, 29, 31, like this. I'm going with the insert diagram. Yes. Now we have to tell what kind of correlation is this. Very good. Question is correct. Whether is it a perfect negative or strong negative or weak negative? Which one? Is it negative? Very good. Sarana is correct. It is called negative strong negative correlations. That's why the diagram comes like this. Just try and draw the trend line. If you go with the trend line, you may get the linear. So see here. Yeah. So straight lines are there. That scores are lies around near to the straight lines. Therefore, it's called negative but in strong. Yeah. Thank you so much for providing the response. I'm going to the next example. Yeah. I'm selecting this score and then I come back to the another color for this check. Yeah, I'm going this color and this color. Yeah. There is a score 30, 31, 29, 32. There is a comparing. I'm going with another diagram. Now you have to tell what kind of, yes. Now what is this one? Yeah, expression is correct. Anita is correct. It's called perfect negative. If I go with trend lines, you may easily understand. The trend lines are linear. It means that all the scores, it lies in the above the straight line. Therefore, the scores are scattered around the straight line only. It's the above the straight line only. Therefore, it's damn sure it may be a perfect negative. Thank you so much. Next, the last example. I'm citing as it is. I'm going with the insert options. I'm going with the scatter diagram. Yes, now we have to tell. Is it a linear? Very good. Is it linear or curvilinear? Is it linear? Actually, this image we can easily found. See here, just if I draw it, this is like a curve shape. It is not a linear, it's like curve shape. It's a curvilinear only. But even though it is called, it is purely a zero correlation. Sometimes you may use the terms a curvilinear also, but it's not a linear. Linear means should be a straight line path, but this is closer. Distributed like in not in a coherent way, it's called zero correlation. Thank you so much. I hope you understand from this image. So here I put this in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 example with the illustration also I'm showing with Excel. I hope you understand the meaning of correlation and its types.